So by popular request, we are doing a video on our bunk bed system.
We are Gay and Robert. 5 years ago, we quit our jobs, sold our house and all of our possessions, and began living the dream of traveling the world with only backpacks on our backs. After flying over 300,000 miles and visiting 82 countries, COVID brought us to a screeching halt. True to our fashion, we improvised and bought a brand new van and built it out in just 6 weeks to explore the United States until international travel opens up.
So by popular request, we are doing a video on our bunk bed system. We have had many questions on how we built it, how it works, and so we will show you videos of us putting it up and us taking it down and trying to get as much detail as we can on how we actually built it, because unfortunately we did not do a time lapse or a video when we were building out the van. So here we go. So the mattress here is an actual bed mattress, bed in a box. It's a 5-inch mattress, and we actually cut this with an electric meat knife and cut it to the measurements of the bunk bed that we wanted. What we did was measured my width and my comfortableness for my top bunk, and so that's how we cut the width and the length for this. And we did the same thing for the lower bunk for Bob, and to also have a comfortable seating couch. I then fabricated these cushions myself. I ordered the fabric online and I did all the sewing, and I made these actual covers for these cushions, which worked out really well.
So I'll give you an overview on how we did the rest of this build for the bunk beds. Of course, this van build that we did has L-track running throughout on the walls and the ceilings and such. But you could do it without such L-track. You could just go ahead and bolt in like eyes or something that would these would hook to on the wall in here. So you don't need L-track to do this build, but it made it nice. For the L-track up here, I actually put in pieces that are bolted through and go across the roof members up there. So it's kind of double strength because I don't want this falling down on me. So it's very secure. These are spine board belts, seat belts, and they're used for people on a stretcher or whatever. And that's where I found them. And they work great because they have these little the clips. So, and I think these hold like 700 pounds, so plenty of thin and gaze, you know, 100 pounds or whatever. Then we took and put, or had built a 80-20, and I believe it's about 73 inches long. I'm 72, so we went a little bit more, but then I, also my feet can overhang on the bottom onto that, onto our electronics wall. So it's plenty of space there. But it's just built out of 80-20. We've created a little back so the mattress doesn't slide that way or slide off either side. This here is just a birch piece that we bought at Home Depot. I think it's a 1/4 inch. Polyurethaned it crazily, so it's all, you know, whatever. Any moisture would not be a problem. And that just screws into here. If we look under here, I think I can, oh no, I can't lift that. Oh no, I don't want to lift it.
No.
So under here then there's frame supports to make this a solid box then, I guess. So these are from US Cargo. You can get them on Amazon or directly through US Cargo. And they're built specifically for attachments to L-track. So this just pulls down and pulls that way. And there you have it. So. They make a different, we have different ones on the wall than we do here, but they work the same. And then to put it back in, it just goes ahead and slides in like this, and then it locks in. So you don't have to worry about that falling down. So these are the swivels that allow the bunk, the top bunk, to pivot up. And originally we were hoping that, not that they would hold a full weight, but they would hold on their own. But no, they're too weak to do so. But these are just bought through, I think McMaster online. I think I got that right. But Granger's or 8020. But what this is, it's just going right on the top of this 8020 here, and you drill through, and then you tap it, and then you put a bolt in there. And both sides, there's bolts that go into the 8020. That was something that I found out on my own. I had no idea you could do that. I'm not even sure that is made to do that, but this is a super strong connection because we use it every night and there's no trouble. So this is just a swivel then to allow it to come up to the horizontal position and then easily go down to the vertical. So we don't have this kind of all over the place. It's actually attached to this with the swivel. Works really well. So then underneath the bottom bunk, we have storage. And we just built out these little compartments, and specifically because we have our pack rafts here. So we have our pack rafts in here with everything included in the pack rafts. So nothing related to pack rafts is anyplace else. So that way we can pull that all out and not forget our life jacket when we go and pack raft or something. So everything's in here. There's two fans in here to pull out the moisture, a fan coming in the back, and a fan coming out the front here. They're super quiet computer fans that our son had told us about. So you can't hear them. I sleep with my head here. I never, ever, ever hear that fan going. So anyway, this is just made out of 8020. These are plastic on the front here. So, you know, we just cut this out and put it in there.
They sit into the channel of the L-track.
Yes, or the 8020.
8020, I mean, sorry.
So it goes into these channels, so it really works out easy. We made this section in the middle for the pillow and the blanket and the straps that hold up the top bunk. So it's nice. It's everything fits right in there. We go ahead and put it in, take it out, and nothing gets like messed up or, you know, doesn't fall into each other. That there is more our miscellaneous stuff. We have lawn chairs. We have our four-wheel drive off-roading stuff like our snatch blocks, straps, and such over there.
And just to show you the attachments on how we attached everything and made the compartments, here's an example of the corner pieces that we have used. This here is an example of a hinge piece to hinge up the base of the bed and the bunk bed itself. And these do come in various sizes. So this is a smaller one compared to the other one that I just showed you. So all of those things can be ordered online.
So it's really nice with the 8020 because you're not drilling any holes. You're not having to move something or, you know, so the only wood we have in the van are these two pieces. And I'm not sure why we did wood, but
yeah.
But anyway, they work great.
Cheap, and it was accessible, yeah, and easy to use.
So that's the only wood we have is that. So everything else is out of the 8020 or the plastic material. Now to bolt in the anything that goes to the floor. So the bunk thing gets bolted into this L-track that's in the bottom. They're on this side, so you can't see them. But they're basically this here, like we have on the refrigerator. They're just angled.
So here's an example here. They're just angled to attach right into the L-track on the floor, and then that makes it very modular, right?
So yeah, so on the couch then, we're able to pull this whole unit out and clean in the back or whatever we wanted to do by just removing those angles that are in here onto the L-track. The L-track is bolted right to the frame of the van, so very sturdy, very strong. This is very lightweight too, so we can pull this out of here easily. Everything can come out of the van, I mean everything, but the wall is a little bit more work.
Challenging, because there's so much more in there.
It can definitely come out, it's just the batteries are a little bit harder to pull out, but this would be super easy to pull out if you wanted to clean behind it or whatever. And then the flooring too, the flooring this is factory floor from Mercedes, but it's notched there, so we could take that out also if we wanted to.
The beauty of the 80-20 is you can create these compartments wherever you want, because obviously you just put this 80-20 here and you attach it with the corner angles and make it however big you want it or small you want it. So it is very versatile. The 80-20 is fabulous from that perspective.
Yeah, we started out not having this compartment, but we wanted a compartment, like I said before, for our pack rest, that everything could fit in here. For one thing, then we can pull the moisture out with those fans, but also everything's here. It's not like, you know, we pack wrapped or we, you know, put them on our backs and we walk in and then we're like, oh, we forgot that. No, everything's in here, so when we pull it out, we know. But so then we're able to make it for our blankets or pillow. So it's, the 80-20 is great. Or if we would have been over here with wood and they're like, oh, we want to make it bigger for this, well, now you have holes that you have to deal with. No big deal most of the time. But in this case, there's no holes. It just attaches into this lip here on this 80-20. So 80-20 is the way to build a van for sure.
The other great thing about the 80-20 is we got these attachments as well to finish off the corners and make it look really nice, and to do all the angles with it. So those obviously we ordered as well through Amazon too.
Yeah, and one thing to know, you can make your 80-20 look much better than ours if you wanted to. They make all different types of corners and connectors. We love this look.
We like the industrial look.
Yeah, we like the industrial look, and we weren't in some of those corners and such are very expensive. So for us, it wasn't worth it, and we went to Denon anyway. We wanted this look, but they're available. You can make it really look very solid. I mean, more like a higher end finished product. So. So to design this bunk bed, we committed to it before we knew how we were going to do it. So I actually did it little by little and tried these swivels and such and tried different heights and all that. But use a product called, or a software called MakeCAD. So if you go on online, you can download it for free. It then allows you to put your 80-20 dimensions in, you know, what type of 80-20 you have, all different types, there's tons of different types. And then it goes ahead and you can build out in a 3D picture the whole bunk bed itself. So I'm actually going to, because our son is going to build out, I'm actually going to put this in MakeCAD. So anyway, but it might take me a little while, but anyway, I did that. And then it gives you what you have to purchase, what lengths of 80-20 you need to purchase. We bought all ours through Granger and then picked it up locally, but it gives you all the cuts then. So you just take a cutoff saw, put on a aluminum blade and just make the cuts, and then go ahead and everything connects together with different items. We have inside L connectors, Gabe was showing. We have the angle plates in the front. So it just depends. Inside here, we have those angles that we showed you earlier. But this is very strong with the connectors. And not only that, this is held up. It's like a basket. So it's not going anyplace. And that was the goal. So that's why we put on three of these, is because I'm down below. It's fairly mission critical that it doesn't fall down on me. But there's no way it's going to fall down with three of these. So even if one failed, which is not, it's not coming down. But that's about it. It's more the concept of the build. So you can, so if your spouse wanted it to be wider, like this is not wide enough for him or her, then you build it out a little further. It's no problem. And then you bring up this this 80-20 in the back just a little bit higher. We wanted to keep it as low on this window as possible, but comfortable enough for Gay to sleep on, and this works. I mean, she is comfortable, but it can definitely be bigger.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a fairly simple process to make it bigger.
And as the base can be bigger too, this can come out, you know, even to here if you wanted to, or further. So that's the beauty of using the 80-20.
Yeah, and you could change it. You could, you know, be like, oh, this is too little. No, we could have done it now. It takes some time to unassemble everything and assemble everything, because it's a puzzle.
Yeah.
But besides the puzzle, it's not hard.
Right.
It's more the puzzle when you put pieces together, whatever. But you could do that.
I think the number one thing about the 80-20 is it's super lightweight. It adds hardly any weight to your van, whereas wood is extremely heavy compared to this 80-20.
Yeah, even if you use like 1x1 or 1x2s on your 80-20, on your wood build, it still adds more weight than this, but it's also more brittle, whatever. This is right. Super strong. Very nice to work with. I mean, I loved, if we ever do another van build out, which probably is in the cards, I will do 80-20.
There's no screws coming out of the wood, nothing pulling away from the wood. It is solid.
Yeah, it is bolted in to each other, and so that's different. But a tip, definitely use the blue Loctite.
Oh, yeah.
not the red, because that's a permanent, but use blue Loctite. We have not, when I first started the build in 80-20, then I'm like, oh, I should probably check to see if this all rattles apart over time. And it's hard to get sometimes out the, even in the blue Loctite. So definitely use blue Loctite and
every nut and bolt.
Yeah. So not only were we putting together a puzzle, because sometimes you're like, okay, this goes in here. You know, it was more also blue Loctite. So seemed like 1,000.
We used a gallon of blue Loctite.
Yeah, it was a ton. it turned out great. The system like this worked out perfect. At night, then I can sit here and still watch TV. I can get in the refrigerator. I can make food. I can use the restroom. Full use. So it does not change anything in the van by having this bunk up here.
Not at all. We absolutely love it and would not change it. Voila!
It's done.
And it's even faster taking everything down. There you have it. It's got to be under a minute's time. We've never timed it, but...
And we do it every morning right away.
So easy. So that is the putting up and taking down. All right. This is how you get up on the bunk bed. Very easy for me. I just hold the strap there. It's not hard at all. I mean, people probably think, well, gosh, it's so hard to get up here and... to lay up here. For me, this is the perfect size. Like we said, you can make this any width you want. It would just take up more of your window view, which we didn't want to do. So we just made it a little bit bigger than myself. No problem rolling over. I can actually sit up in here.
And one nice thing is when she gets off, I'm laid back in there. So she actually has a step down here. So I don't need to like move, or she doesn't need to, you know, step down on my leg.
So with the base being wider, because we wanted more space for sitting, that's where I stepped down. And for me to get down, again, it's just as easy. Make sure you can see my foot down here with the camera. I just step down like that. I hold on to the
seatbelt if I have to, whatever, it doesn't matter. So then I can get up and Bob can continue laying down there. I can walk through here, you know, get back and forth without any problem, just like he can. And that's why we love this build and makeup. We're not having to, have this space taken up. It doesn't slide over and all this space is taken. We wanted the living room feel. We didn't want that entire space taken up by a bed back there, and it works for us. And I know people talk about, man, I miss cuddling with my partner in the morning. I actually crawl down here while Bob's still sleeping. Then I lay down with him on the side, and then we get our cuddle time in the morning or at night as well. So that works too for us.
You know, one thing that people will complain about or have questions like, do you keep your bed up all day? You know, do you just leave it? As far as not with us, but other van builds, because it's too much of a pain. As you saw in our video, it takes seconds, I mean, literally seconds, maybe 30 seconds to put it up and down. Yeah. So we immediately take that down.
Right.
And so we're into a living room look immediately. We never keep it in the bunk bed status because it's too quick.
Yeah. It's too easy to put up and down. Under a minute for sure. Probably 30 seconds. We should actually time it sometime. But you can see on the video how fast and easy it is to put up and down.
So that might be one of the big advantages, is that you can go from bedroom to living room to bedroom very quickly. Just you like don't that. Even have to think about it. You don't have to go, oh, I have to make the bed. I don't do that. No, it's super simple.
Yeah. And the way we even have our blankets, you know, we have them all laid out. We roll them up in our pillow. Our sheets stay in there. Our blankets stay in there. Boom. Those go underneath. Those pull out. It's a slick system. So, yeah, that's how I get up and down into the bed. So here's examples of all the little attachments and brackets that we used when building all of our cabinetry and our bunk bed system. Here's a little corner piece, that finishing piece that goes on the edge of the 80-20. It just snaps right into this hole in here itself, as you can see. This is the triangles that make the finishing corners look much better. Here's the hinge piece that we used on the bunk bed. We also used them on our cabinet doors, and I can quick show you that. These are our overhead doors on our cabinetry to open and close them. This is just a piece of the L-track. You know, obviously it's cut into a smaller piece, but I wanted to show you an example of that. Here's the 80-20 itself. It's all square. Here's the ends where you can drill things into or attach things to that as well. Here is the triangular piece that holds each piece together. You can put these obviously on any corner. And then those just attach with bolts going through them. Here's these little bolts that are specialized for the 80-20. When you attach things to them, you have your bolt itself, which uses an Allen wrench. Then, of course, that goes on there. But these actually go right into the 80-20. And then when you turn it, it then self-locks itself. So then this can't come out. So as you tighten down the bolt, this little end then turns on itself in there, and then you can no longer move it. The glory of it is once you loosen it up lightly, then it can just slide around on the 80-20 itself. So very, very sleek system for that too. And that's how you attach these. You would use a bolt and one of those on the other side, and then that attaches in there. And then this little piece locks itself in into the 80-20. Same thing on here. You use those behind your bolts, and then that locks into the 80-20. Here's that L piece that we were talking about that slides in and out of the L track, and that can also connect your pieces together. That goes into here, and then another piece of 80-20, and this would go up here, and you would just slide that in there, but you use an 80-20 piece there.
So hopefully that answered people's questions, and
it's kind of a slick deal, and it was like something that we developed on the fly. So
yeah, please leave your comments below. Ask us any question that you have. We feel like we have put significant amount of time into this build, and we certainly can give you measurements if you want. If it comes down to that, do live shots for you, whatever, to help you build your bunk bed system in any vehicle. Thanks for watching, guys. Hit the subscribe button and leave your comments below. Have a good night. Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys. It sound right, boys.